After having no superior tools to our naked eyes to explore the universe, the 17th century ushered in a revolution with the adoption of the telescope. Then, in 1671, Italian astronomer Giovanni Cassini was observing Saturn, already known to possess a giant moon, Titan, and discovered another moon, Iapetus. While Cassini would go on to make many other discoveries about Saturn, including numerous other moons, Iapetus was one of the strangest things anyone had ever seen in the sky. Saturn, like all of the gas giant worlds in our solar system, has its own unique and rich system of satellites, largely in the form of moons and rings. The main rings are by far the most prominent feature, with small young moons and moonlets inside. Outside of the main rings, Saturn possesses 8 significant moons. Of these 8 moons, Iapetus is not only the outermost one, but also possesses 3 specific features that make it unique. It orbits out of Saturn's plane and has a two-toned appearance, an equatorial bulge and a giant ridge. How did it form and develop these strange properties? 350 years later, we still don't know. Iapetus has a low density of only 1.083 grams per cubic centimeter, just a little more than liquid water, implying that it composed primarily of water, with rock making up less than a quarter of its composition. Iapetus is the third largest moon orbiting Saturn, with a diameter of 914 miles, 1,472 kilometers. Although its radius is about two-fifths that of Earth's moon, its icy composition means that it is only about 2% as massive. Much like the Earth, Moon, or Sun, Iapetus is not a perfect sphere. However, whereas the Earth and Sun slightly bulge at the equator and appear compressed at their poles due to the balance between gravitation and the angular momentum caused by their rotation, a condition known as hydrostatic equilibrium, Iapetus' properties are all wrong for its motion. Its equator has a diameter of 1,492 kilometers compared to its pole-to-pole diameter of just 1,424 kilometers, which would represent hydrostatic equilibrium if Iapetus rotated a full 360 degrees every 16 hours, but it does not. Iapetus is tightly locked to Saturn, meaning it rotates only once every 79 days. In addition, the Cassini mission's visit to Iapetus showed something entirely novel and unexpected: an enormous equatorial ridge spanning 1,300 kilometers across, or nearly the full diameter of the planet. The ridge is about 20 kilometers wide, 13 kilometers high, and follows the equator almost perfectly. There are multiple disconnected segments apart from the main ridge, numerous isolated peaks and sections where the single ridge appears to break apart into 3 parallel ridges. It's the only world in the solar system with any such feature, and every theory struggles to explain just how this world came to have these equatorial properties. Iapetus has a distinctly two-toned color. Believe it or not, back when Iapetus was first discovered, this was precisely the explanation advanced by Cassini himself for what he was saying. Unlike the other two conundrums, however, this puzzle has finally been solved, a feat that would have been virtually impossible in Cassini's time. As you can see from a full color map of Iapetus, The leading hemisphere is extremely dark, as if it is reddish brown in color, while the trailing hemisphere is snow white, covered in various volatile ices. If you have ever driven your car on a highway through a swarm of insects, this view of Iapetus might bring up some visceral memories for you. Because only the leading hemisphere, or the one that's analogous to your car's windshield, is the one plowing into the matter directly in front of it, only one side gets covered in bugs. Of course, there are no bugs in space, but beyond the main rings of Saturn, there is something that functions as a source of darkened matter, a diffuse enormous cloud of matter. This matter isn't visible in the optical, but rather was only detectable because of our infrared space telescopes that could detect the radiations emitted by dust that's been warmed by the sun. As it turns out, there is an extremely large but low-mass rings of matter, inclined to both Saturn's rotational direction and also to Iapetus' orbit, that spread out across a distance of nearly 100 million kilometers. The reason for this outer diffuse dust ring is simple, straightforward, and completely counterintuitive. It comes from the only other large moon in the Saturnian system, the captured body Phoebe, which orbits almost completely opposite to Saturn's rotational direction. This captured icy body emits volatile when exposed to the sun, and is now thought to be the ultimate cause of Iapetus' two-toned color. By orbiting in the opposite direction to how the particles in the Phoebe ring orbit, Iapetus accrues somewhat darker material, preferentially on one side only, as the volatile ices on that side preferentially sublimate. It leaves the darker deposits behind, while the ice-rich side gets thicker and more reflective. That's the generally accepted explanation for why Iapetus has this two-toned nature. Iapetus does not orbit in the same plane as the rest of Saturnian system. Iapetus travels around Saturn approximately at a distance of 2.2 million miles, 3.5 million kilometers, the most distant of its major satellites. Orbiting Saturn at more than double the distance of Titan or Hyperion, Iapetus is inclined at 15.5 degrees with respect to the rest of the Saturnian system, a difficult property to explain. Unlike other closer moons, Iapetus suffers very little tidal heating from the massive planet. As a result, the skin of the satellite does not show signs of melting and resurfacing that may have smoothed the outer layer of the other moons. Here we are in 2023, more than 350 years after Iapetus' discovery, and we still cannot decisively explain it all. Such is the nature and such are the limitations of the scientific process.